यह बिहार बोर्ड मस्ने बड़े मी रॉबिन एंड दयाल यूजुअल वाइल्ड लाइफ गाइस आफ्टर लॉन्ग टाइम वी आर एंटरिंग मस्ने बड़े सो वी हैव टू मेक एन ई पास एंड थिंग्स लाइक दैट लेट्स सी हाउ दे चेक व्हाट दे डू हाउ मच प्रोटोकॉल इज बीइंग फॉलोड एंड व्हाट वी गेट इन मस्ने बड़े आल्सो
दैट्स द कर्नाटका एग्जिट गेट नॉट वेरी क्राउडेड It's around 11 o'clock in the morning and we will enter Tamil Nadu soon through the check post.
எல்லா ஹெல்மெட்லயும் இருக்கு எல்லா மொபைலும் இருக்கு ஃபாரஸ்ட்ல எடுக்க கூடாது
போட்டோல நம்ம
வண்டி நிறுத்தி எடுக்க
கூடாது சார் வந்துட்டு ஃபாரஸ்ட்ல இங்க செக் போஸ்ட்ல வந்தா வீடியோ எடுக்க கூடாது சார் நாங்க போய் அவங்க கிட்ட சொல்றேன் நீங்க போய் அங்க சொல்லிருங்க
ஓகே மேடம்
என்ட்ரிங் தமிழ்நாடு ஆஃப்டர் தட் ஃபன்னி ஆர்கியுமெண்ட் வித் தி லேடி ஹூ இஸ் கலெக்டிங் 30 ரூபீஸ் as green tax for Nilgiris god knows why we thought she didn't want her to be photographed or videographed that is our perspective and but then she claims that Mao's people and we should not take pictures of you know the checkpoints and everything convincing Ooty guys about Ooty we are you know what we say little knowledge is very harmful was the funny story there anyways let's move on we'll have to enter Masnagudi now it's not a jungle safari today so we will be going to Masnagudi basically So that is the turn from Teppakadu. Teppakadu is the place, and you take a left here to go to Masnagudi. Straight goes to Gudlur actually, and it's a very narrow road. This piece of the bridge is was actually built during the British times. It is a military bridge actually, and our government never had the time to build an alternate bridge and you know take care of this temporary structure. This temporary structure itself, this one exactly what we are going through now. It's been there for at least say 80-100 years as far as I know and the government is least bothered so as we go here this is the Mudumalai zone or the Mudumalai elephant camp zone on the right side tourists can there are elephants which are fed here and they are tamed elephants so tourists can go there at a stipulated time around 5:30 in the evening I guess is the ticket and they can have although there is an elephant on the left side This is you know lovely. Left side has got the log house. You can stay there. It's a government place. And elephants like this come here to for graze, to take bath, etc. You know it's a lovely sight. You know elephants any day a lovely sight. Moving on towards Masnagudi, we're actually going to the Singara Estate or the Singara Road. Where we plan to, you know, search for some birds for bird photography today. So this is a notorious area. You will find jeep drivers coming in the center of the road asking you for safaris. You need not stop. Just be careful and move on. It is a waste actually. This safari is just around the road, so it is as equivalent to you to go into in your own car to Ooty. So here we take a right. This is the Masnagudi Junction, and this leads us to the. picturesque place called Singara Estate and we are traveling through the we will travel through the Singara Road see beautiful cows as we enter it starts villages cow herds these are all forest cows they will graze in the forest they will you know dung in the forest which are mutually beneficial to each other nowadays they don't have permission in many places in Tamil Nadu they have stopped this forest grazing of cows which has been harmful to a lot of people as we go on or do in the distance you can see the blue mountains the Nilgiris these are just the foothills of the Ooty Nilgiris in general terms we call it Ooty but you know Nilgiris is the main name for it trees are dry as you know it is summer now as we go but these are lovely drives it's a single road bamboos on both sides this is a controversy there is a small tunnel here I think it is for the hydraulic project but people refer this to escape routes of Tipu Sultan etc god knows what it is about If you know, let me know. So as we move on, I can't, you know, stop covering the roads because the best part of the trip is the roads only. Okay. So this is the main area. But as we enter the estate, it will become more green, as I told you. As we enter the estate, the complete atmosphere has changed. See the difference in greenery here. Just because these are maintained estates which are watered regularly. And these are hilly zones. This is the last hill coming down. So we will drive down till we are just watching now on both sides to look for any bird activity or any different thing which is roaming around, and we'll note the places, and while we return we will stop there and try to take some photographs. The birds are special here. The preview which I showed in the beginning itself would made you realize how special the birds will be. So just wait and watch. I am as curious as all of us are. Let's see if we get what I put in the preview. Hopefully we are lucky enough for that. There is a small guest house there. Not a guest house, it's a seven quarters. As you can see in the front. And that is where the way the tea, the way the coffee, and you know the process, not the process, the you know, selling happens here, or the collection point for the produce. And a couple of laborers live here also. So this is a private estate. Please remember that this is a private estate. It is not a government estate. And entry is restricted. But the owners are good enough. Sometimes they let us, you know, pass, have a look around. But you're not supposed to stop for long and, you know, really disturb them out. So that entrance which you see in front is the reason for all this. This is the hydroelectric project of the Paikara division which is coming here. So I was referring to the tunnel there. So there's no entry here. Before there used to be an entry if you get correct permissions and everything. But now I don't know the case, but I think with permission you can enter and see the reservoir, dam and everything. A little government process, you know. Yes, we are back at the spot and look at Robin. He's doing a survey. Birdman Robin. This is the tree. This is the fig tree. And this is the place which the bird comes for, or comes to eat for, you know. If you have not seen figs in person, that is the fig, which have fallen down actually. You know, the tree was very high, I couldn't capture there. So this is what has fallen down. And we need to look around. It is a big patient game. Binoculars, cameras, whatever you have to, you know, do the zoom activity. Keep zooming and keep looking around. Four of us are looking around in all four sides. Hopefully we say, oh, he started clicking. Now I know what is clicking. I think the bird has arrived on the tree. Hey, that's what we were waiting for. And this season, again, we are lucky enough to see the hornbill, great Indian hornbill. Look at the colors, look at the surroundings. So that is so special. That is the reason we come here, travel here and do these pictures. And this place is again full of Malabar's giant squirrels also. See, that one is a squirrel jumping. And that one is a close-up just for your eyes. Because of the figs, there's deers also which have come in. Lovely to see them all, you know. Lovely to see them all in one place. More pictures, more pictures, more pictures is what we are doing. And they are showcasing only the hornbill here. We got the other hornbill, the Malabar hornbill also here, the blue color bird. But this is the main focus. This is what we came for. This is the tree. If you will watch it in a computer, you can really see the bird jumping there. I don't know how far it will be in small screens. But this is what we are capturing. This is the real skin there. Okay. Whoa, and that's the fly too. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. The sound, the way it flies. Mesmerizing. It's one of the hugest birds here. in India and is available in Valparai, here in Masnagudi and a couple of places in North India and Dandeli too. So very rare, very beautiful a bird. Given a chance, don't miss it. Just enjoy the bird. Sun under the trees, my lucky charm, or you know, my favorite photograph. More pictures, more birds, that is what we do. See, some watch, some take videos, some take pictures, and a lot of pictures. We almost took almost 100 pictures now, 100 good pictures, and all of them are yet to be processed. So you'll find them in my Facebook very soon. That's it. And we are on our way back. It was a beautiful afternoon. Well spent 3 hours. You know, lucky that the owners were patient with us. I spoke to one of them and he was patient with us to allow us to, you know, visit for about 2 hours. He had just asked us not to disturb people. So as we return, I'm not covering the whole road now. Anything special, I'll let you know. Oh my god, that elephant is still there on the same spot near Tepakadam. So that is what, these elephants will stay here forever, you know. No missing at all. Hope you like the video. Please do subscribe. I'll update you on many more soon.